Find customers for your products. Find products for your customers. Good evening, gentlemen. I am Hyder Ali, and today the topic of our presentation is market segmentation. And this presentation will be presented by me and my group members, Mr. Usman and Mr. Zubair. Next, please. So let me start with the very basic definition of market segmentation. Market segmentation is the process of dividing a market into distinct subsets of consumers with common needs or characteristics and selecting one or more segments to target with a distinct marketing mix. There are basically 9 phases of market segmentation. Geographic segmentation, demographic segmentation, psychographic, psychological, socio-cultural, use-related, use situation, and lastly, benefits segmentation, and lastly is Hyder segmentation. But in this presentation, we will only discuss about demographic segmentation. Demographic segmentation is refers to the vital and measurable statistics of population. Demographic segmentation helps to locate the target market, but like the socio-cultural segmentation or psychographic segmentation tells us how individuals or its members think and feel. And the one other thing about demographic segmentation is that it helps to locate a target market. And the other most important thing is it is most accessible and cost-effective way to identify the target market. It, demographic segmentation, the people say about this that most secondary data or the census data is expressed in terms of demographic segmentation. It is easier to measure than other segmentation variable. For example, this demographic segmentation study research shows that mature adult market, like 50 plus market, has a much greater proportion of disposable income than its gender counterparts. There are 6 bases for demographic segmentation, or 6 characteristics: age, sex, marital status, income, education, and occupation. Now the next part will be presented by Mr. Usman.
Product needs and interests often vary with consumer age. We have young investors and old investors. Young investors who tend to see in a long-term gains, and old investors who tend to see an immediate gain. We have baby boomers. Baby boomers are the largest demographic segmentation of US nation. They have 78 million of consumers. They are holding 70% of nation wealth. They are born between 1946 and 1964. 40% of baby boomers think that they are living their best years of their life nowadays. And 40% of baby boomers think that they are living their good years are ahead of their life. And 20% are 50-50. Many marketers have carved themselves a niche in the marketplace, hence introduce a spurred ketchup. As we know that ketchup is in red in color, but they introduce their ketchup in green color. And another example is Aqua Velva, a 50-year-old brand of men's aftershave, now introducing for younger male, adult males with a new product called Ice Palm. Next is McDonald's advertising budget. McDonald's spend 80% of their budget on advertising on TV channels. So, but nowadays they are spending on internet because using social media more than television. Now we have age effect. Age effect occurs due to chronic age, and cohort effects occurs due to growing up during a specific time periods. For example, age effect. In age effect, like the people who play golf, is their age is above than 50 or more than 50. And cohort effect, for example, if a person who like golf music in his or her youth, but after he crossed the age of 50 years, he also like rock and roll music as well. Now, sex. Like age, generally are quite frequently a distinguishing segmentation variable. Association of products, for example, hair coloring and cosmetics. As we know that this example is associated with women's. Next is tools of shaving preparation, associated with men. Uske baad, gender is known, nowadays sex role is blurred. Gender is no longer an accurate way to distinguish consumer in some product categories. For example, dual income households, both men and women are doing jobs. Men and women differ in the terms, the way they look, and internet user. For example, in commercial ads, women are casting for tools and men are casting for cosmetic ads. For example, now they are using internet. How they search on internet? Men are hunger for information that needed for hungry, for example, food, and women are for entertainment, education. Next will be presented by Zubair.
Marital status. Traditionally, the family has been the focus of many marketers and for their product and services, and the household continues to be a relevant consuming unit. Marketers are interested in the number and kind of households who buy or own such a product. They are also interested in the demographic and media profile household decision makers to develop an appropriate decision making. After that, market segmentation has been divided into different groups that are single, divorced individuals, single parents, and dual income married couples. For every group, there is a different market segment. Just like, for example, for the single household, there is an example of bumblebee tuna. It's a type of food product which can be easily opened in can, like a small microwave oven and 2 cup coffee makers. Also, for a single person, he doesn't need to buy big refrigerator. He can buy small refrigerator that he is satisfied. Next one, please. Income, education, and occupation. Income has long been an important variable for distinguishing between market segment. Marketer commonly segment targets on the basis of income because they feel that it is a strong indicator for the ability to pay for the product or a specific model of the product. For example, many retailers such as the Bazaar has a tagline of "Isse sasta aur kaha," it means it doesn't get cheaper than this. Successfully have targeted lower and middle class income people, and now Big Bazaar has been growing faster in India. Income is combined with other demographic variable to more accurately define target markets. To illustrate, a high income can be combined with the age, or it can be combined with both age and occupation status to buy status. Education, occupation, and income tend to be closely correlated in almost a cause and effect relationship. If a person is having high occupation, he produces high income, and his education is also excellent or high. There are only two types of occupation. It can be a blue collar occupation and a white collar occupation. Blue collar occupation are those people who have low income, low occupation, and low education. Whereas white collar occupation are those occupation which have high occupation, high income, and high education.
Any questions, guys? Thank you so much.